السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الدين إن شاء الله تعالى with سورة القيامة and go through verses 14 to 18 إن شاء الله. 14 to verse 18. سورة القيامة سورة number 75. So open the مصحف إن شاء الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وسيت يجودي in the beginning. بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة. ولو ألقى معاذيره. لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. إن علينا جمعه وقرآنه. فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه. ثم إن علينا بيانه. So this is 19. I said 18, so it's 19 inshallah. بل الإنسان إخفاء. بل الإنسان على نفسه باء. The باء is light and the صاد is heavy. بصيرة. And make sure the ha at the end is said. ولو ألقى معاذيره. لا تحرك. The ra is light and the kaf. Make sure that you say it. And the air comes out, but it's not something that you stop there. لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. لتعجل به. إن نون الشدة take two counts. علينا جمعه وقرآنه. The kaf is heavy. فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه ثم إن the noon with shadda takes two counts and the same thing with the noon ميم النون ثم إن علينا بيانه. The translation: Nay, man will be a witness against himself, though he may put forth his excuses. Move not your tongue concerning the Quran, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to make haste therewith. It is for us to collect it and to give you the ability to recite it. And when we have recited it to you, then follow you its recital. Then it is for Allah to make it clear to you. So the ayah here, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. After what's mentioned before about the day of judgment and when the human beings would say, أَيْنَ الْمَفَرُّ, where is the way out? How can they flee? No fleeing. Everyone will be gathered and everybody will be resurrected. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mustaqar. The end of things will be to our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the human beings will be informed what they did, their actions, what they sent forward and what's left behind. And that's why the next ayah, بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا. Nay, the reality is the human being is upon himself basira. That means he witness against himself. He knows exactly, we know exactly what we did. وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَذِيرًا, even if he bring all kinds of excuses and apologies, or even if he denies, this is what it means. And it will be said in the day of judgment, اِقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. Read your book, the book of deeds. The book of deeds will be for every person will have their book of deeds. So read your book. كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. That is sufficient on that day for you to be the hasib and for you to hold yourself accountable, because this is your actions. This is what you did. And Ali ibn Abi Talha, he said that Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, He said in the tafsir of the ayah بل الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة. He said سمعه وبصره ويداه ورجلاه وجوارحه. His hearing and his eyes, his eyesight and his hands and his legs and his physical parts of his body will witness for him or against him, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned that in Surah Fussilat. يوم تشهد عليهم ألسنتهم وأيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون. Their tongues will speak, their hands, their legs. So everything will be either for the person or against them. And also Qatada said that a person will witness over himself. You know, and he said, if you wish, wallahi, you would see this human being. It's, we don't have to go far, it's ourselves. We know. But the amazing thing about the human beings is that if you wish, wallahi, you would find this human being very critical. He sees the shortcomings and the faults of the people and their sins. غافلاً عن ذنوبه. He's heedless about his own sins. And this is what the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, إن أحدكم لا يبصر القذاة في عين أخي. One of you would see the smallest dirt in the eyes of his brother, but he doesn't see الجذع في عيني, or he doesn't see the trunk of the tree in his eyes. So if that's the case, that means, you know, it's if we're honest with ourselves, we get to know our shortcomings. So human beings will witness for or against themselves. So that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. And nobody will be punished unless they have been warned. وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَذِيرًا. Even if he throws his ma'adhir, even if he brings his apologies, and he would say, apologize, I'm sorry, I didn't know, or he would claim that he didn't know or so. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes him, that means he knew and he turned away from the truth. Even if he bring his evidences, even if you do whatever you know that people usually do in this world, it's not going to benefit them in the hereafter. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ الظَّالِمِينَ مَعْذِرَتُهُمْ. The ظالمين, the wrongdoers, it's not going to benefit them, their apology. Why? Because this is the time where people need to regret, and this is the time, meaning in this life, to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the ma'adhir, or the excuses in the Day of Judgment, is not going to be accepted. It's either the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for the sinners, or the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the disbelievers. And that, of course, shows how that we need to constantly be in state of repentance and to work on ourselves and to be patient with the deen of Allah. Then the ayat says, لا تحرك به لسانك لتعجل به. This is with regards to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, do not be in haste when the Quran is recited unto you. Why? Because as it's reported by Bukhari and Muslim, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever the Quran comes down unto him, he used to move his tongue. He wants to memorize it. You know, when someone is saying something to you and you want to memorize it, you start moving your tongue. So when that was happening to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, out of the fear that he might forget it or something like this, or the so much eagerness to memorize it, so this was something that it was, you know, a struggle for the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed these verses to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, saying that don't worry about it, it's going to be in your heart, and then you would recite it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guaranteeing for the Quran to be saved in the heart of the Prophet والسلام, so you don't have to work into memorizing it, basically. So this is instruction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam to not to struggle with moving his tongue and things like this with the Quran. So لا تحرك به, do not move your tongue with it, meaning with the Quran. لتعجل به, to be in haste in trying to memorize it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, وَلَا تَعْجَلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يُقْضَى إِلَيْكَ وَحْيُهُ. Do not be in haste with the Quran before the wahi is completed. وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا, and say, oh my Lord, increase my knowledge. إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا جَمْعَهُ وَقُرْآنَهُ. Then إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا, indeed upon us is جَمْعَهُ, the jam'ah of the Quran, the collection of the Quran, the presence of the Quran in your heart, and the recitation of it. So if you're worried, O Messenger of Allah, about forgetting it, don't worry. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this message will be saved. So إن علينا, it's upon us, جمعه وقرآنه. And the Quran will be compiled, will be present in your heart, and even the recitation of it. And that's an important meaning here to observe, is this is the decree of Allah. This is the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the Quran is saved. It can never be altered. Right? If people do individual things, I mean, but of course the Quran will stay in place in every word of it. If this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the decree of Allah, the qadr of Allah is established by means. So if someone, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, made him one of the means to establish what already is decreed and decided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a great honor. So therefore, for example, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, when they compiled the Quran and things like this, this is to honor them. And they are basically the means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed for the wahi, for the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be saved. And the same thing when we memorize the Quran, when we learn the knowledge of the deen of Allah, to pass it to the next generation and to bring the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts and so on. This is all decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to establish the deen. So if someone is doing this, this is a great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it says, فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ. If we recite it, I mean, if the angel recited unto you, فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ. And the angel, Jibreel alayhi salam, he recites it to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recited to Jibreel alayhi salam. فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ. Follow its Qur'an. Follow the recitation of the Qur'an and read it as you have heard it. And the Prophet ﷺ did that in the most perfect way. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they took it from the Prophet ﷺ, and then it became a chain of narration from one generation to the other, reading the Quran exactly the way that the Prophet ﷺ heard it, the way that he recited it to them. ثُمَّ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا بَيَانَهُ, which means then upon us is its bayan, its clarification, to make it clear. So that means after memorization and after the recitation, we will be the ones to clarify it and to make it clear. That means the tafsir, the bayan of the Quran, it's also from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will be to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. As Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said, بَعْدَ حِفْظِهِ وَتِلَاوَتِهِ نُبَيِّنُهُ لَكَ وَنُوَضِّحُ وَنُلْهِمُكَ مَعْنَاهُ عَلَى مَا أَرَدْنَا وَشَرَعْنَا. That means after memorizing it and reciting it, we will make it clear for you and we will inspire you the meaning of it according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants and according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala legislate. So which is a clear evidence that the Quran is not left like this without clarification. It's been clarified, it's been explained by the Quran, by the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, by the and this is where the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, they took from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and they acted upon it. So, and the halal and the haram will be explained clearly. So this is by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything is perfected. Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said something, a great benefit here. He said in this ayah is there's adab, manners to learn when a person is seeking knowledge. Is that the muta'allim, or the one that is seeking knowledge, should not be in haste to get the information or the knowledge from the teacher before the teacher finishes explaining the mas'ala or the matter that he's explaining, right? And if he finishes, then the student will ask of what he didn't understand and things like this. So this is one of the etiquettes, and a person would listen first and then ask questions. And learning with just asking questions is not learning. This is, we have to ask, of course, if we don't know something. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. But if you want to learn the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you learn and then you ask of what's not clear and things like this. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, this was said to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and it shows how that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected the wahi, the revelation from Allah. And this is by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is left for the people is to be obedient to Allah and to follow the wahi. So when you look at the words, بل الإنسان, بل is, they call it حرف إضراب. What's before it is denied by بل, which means nay, as in this context. بل الإنسان, the human being or mankind, على upon نفسه, upon himself, بصيرة, from بصر, بصاد, رأى أن البصيرة is more than seeing, it's more of the proper vision of things. He knows exactly, he can witness for himself or against himself. ولو ألقى, and if he ألقى, ألقى is from لام قاف ياء, presents, comes from also throwing something. So ولو ألقى معاذيرة, excuses, from عين ذل راء. العذر is the apology, is the excuses. قالوا معذرة إلى ربكم, like this, معاذيرة, this is the plural. لا تحرك, do not move, from حاء راء كاف. And الحركة is the opposite of when something is not moving. So لا تحرك, do not move, لا تحرك به, with it, لسانك, your tongue, from لام سين نون. لتعجل, اللام here is the reason, لام التعليل, تعجل, to be in haste, from عين جيم لام. And العجلة من الشيطان, the haste. وعجلت إليك ربي لترضى, موسى عليه السلام said I was in haste to you, O my Lord, for you to be pleased with me. العجلة is always not something good unless a person is turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. إن علينا, indeed upon us, جمعه, from جمع, compiling, collecting, وقرآنه, and recitation, from قرأ. فإذا قرأناه, so if we have recited it, فاتبع, follow, from تأبى عين, قرآن, its recitation. ثم إن علينا, then indeed upon us, بيانة, from باء ياء نون, which is the explanation, which is the clarity of it, and so on. So this is with these verses, and of course with the Arab is easy. بل الإنسان مبتدأ, الإنسان على نفسه بصيرة, and بصيرة is becomes the خبر, or what completes the sentence. ولو ألقى فعل ماض, and the فاعل is hidden. معاذيرة, this is مفعول به, and this is حال, this is the state that has been explained. لا تحرك, so تحرك here is مجزوم with a سكون, because لا is called لناهية, it's forbidding, the forbidding لا, do not move. And the فاعل also is hidden, لا تحرك meaning you. به لسانك مفعول به. لتعجل, again فعل, this is مضارع, present tense, because it comes after لام التعليل, لام of the reason. If the present tense comes after it, it becomes منصوب with a فتحة. إن علينا, إن علينا جمعه, اسم إن, and قرآنه معطوف, and the which is علينا is the خبر, إن is mentioned first. فإذا قرأناه فاتبع قرآنه, which means إذا is a conditional statement, قرأناه past tense, and فاعل, and the مفعول also present here, فاتبع, this is command, فعل أمر, and the فاعل is hidden, قرآنه مفعول به. ثم إن علينا بيانا, then ثم here is عطف, and then إن علينا, indeed علينا, like the first thing, the same thing as إن علينا جمعه. والله أعلم. So we'll stop here inshallah, and if you, as you see here, the benefits again very clear, and we need to reflect upon these verses and to see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved this book, and the saving of the book in memorizing, reciting, and understanding the tafsir of it is all saved for the ummah. But the ummah need to seek that ilm to show the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam, and that human beings, they know their mistakes, and we should be aware of our mistakes. And one of the great favors of Allah, if someone would advise you with your mistakes, but unfortunately many people, which is something inside of us as human beings, we don't like to be criticized. But if we really understand and have the strong iman in our hearts, this is something that a Muslim should appreciate, so that he would correct himself before it's too late, when there's no excuses then in the day of judgment. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our life with the book of Allah, the Quran. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وصحبه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.